Each day the flag goes high as the sun starts to pour down its rays inside the campus. While the national flag hoisting goes on, there is a complete silence in the campus. Everyone stands still without a single movement. This is the very first routine of Sainik School. The cadets are taught to pay respect to the national flag more than everything. Is not as simple as we see in other schools. The khaki what they wear, which usually make them tough from inside. Their each day is not so easy, but they really enjoy the toughness inside the campus. They are not allowed to stand at one place until the sun does not go down. Their feet keep stamping the whole campus throughout the day. They have only one motto for being here, is to get a quality education and tough body. From the shine of shoes to the beret on the head, their head always held high. There is a small history of Sainik schools. The idea of Sainik schools was proposed by former Defence Minister V. Krishna Menon.
I, Venyalal Krishnan Krishna Menon, solemnly affirm that I will bear true faith and allegiance
with the purpose of rectifying the regional and class imbalance among the officers of Indian military and developing young minds into officers for tomorrow. The first Sainik school was established in Satara, Maharashtra in 1961. Just after a few days, a new Sainik school came up in Kunchpura, Haryana. More than half a century later, there are 25 Sainik schools that have given thousands of brilliant officers to the Indian Defence Forces. As the banner reads, the nursery of future military leadership, where kids enter and gentlemen leave. Welcome to Sainik School, Ambikapur.
In year 2000, when the state of Chhattisgarh was formed, Sainik School Rewa went with Madhya Pradesh. In 2008, Sainik School Ambikapur was formed and it functioned for almost 7 years from the temporary location. In November 2015, it shifted to its permanent campus at Mendrakala. And finally, Sainik School Ambikapur had its own campus.
A typical day here starts with the morning sun witnessing the young cadets out in the field to embrace a career that is so physically challenging with no lack of adventures. After a quick morning roll call, there is a 45 minute of physical training. They run few kilometers to make their body warm up before starting the exercise. During this 45 minute session, they are under the supervision of instructors with the venerated military training, who drill them to the very limits of fitness.
Physical training. यह सैनी स्कूल के अंदर एक महत्वपूर्ण विषय है। यहाँ पे जितना वैल्यू बाकी सब्जेक्ट को दिया जाता है उतना ही वैल्यू यहाँ पे फिजिकल ट्रेनिंग को दिया जाता है, क्योंकि सैनिक स्कूल का मेन उद्देश्य है कि यहाँ से हुआ कैडेट पास आउट आर्म फोर्सेस में उसको ज्वाइन करने के लिए प्रेरित करना है। ज़्यादातर आर्म स्कूलों के अंदर और सैनिक स्कूल के अंदर फिजिकल ट्रेनिंग को ज़्यादा महत्व दिया जाता है।
Many different exercises make each part of their body tough and strong. The physical training periods are all encompassing and include yoga, ground exercise, obstacles courses and drill. It is not only enables the cadets physically but also inculcates the qualities of obedience and discipline. The significance of uniform in military can never be truly emphasized. The code of the right dress in the right place at the right time is what military lives by.
When a cadet put on his uniform, he must look smart because it's not a casual dress, it's a uniform which he proud on.
The tradition of dress check by the senior cadets is to educate the younger cadets that the uniform radiates honor of the bearer. It is an integral part of the discipline of the institution. The uniform check starts right from the shoes and ends up at the beret on the head.
Turnout is very important in this school. So every day when you put up your uniform, you must dress it properly. Everything, starting from your boot to your beret, must be in a proper way. First of all, your shoes must be polished. Next, whenever you put on your dresses, let this alignment from your belt, chip, button and your nose all should be aligned in a single line.
To me, the feeling which one gets while wearing a khaki, it's something which only a Sainik school can get it, can understand just too well. Because when I wear a khaki, I feel a sense of pride, a sort of confidence when I walk. I feel an authority inside me when I'm wearing a khaki. Because it's something which gives me an identity. A khaki would determine who is a Sainik school cadet outside. And that's an identity which I sever whole of my life.
Being the flag bearer of defense officer, the cadets are taught to dress perfectly. The nameplate should be placed at the right place. The line of shirt should be matched up to the line of zip of the trouser. The shoes must be polished perfectly. The cadets yield their khaki with immense power and responsibility. After an absolutely draining season of training, the cadets refuel their unrusting engines at the cadets' mess. The mess culture of military institutions is truly sublime. The one here is nothing less. In the cadets' mess, all the cadets dine together along with their teachers.
Cadet mess is run by a school and providing nutritious and tasty food to its 600 cadets. The morale and joy of the cadet is very high.
The mess too, for the cadets, is a field of learning where they are taught to the proper etiquettes of holding a fork and a knife, while a meticulously designed meal plan nourishes them and fuels their taste buds. Inside the campus, the cadets are taught to believe in discipline. They are told to march properly inside the campus. The appointments have the responsibility to make sure of this.
When they are marching from here, they should be total heel-to-heel march. Their hands should be totally all in uniform motion, especially the last files. Ask all your house vice captains that they should march with the last files and there should be proper march. Is that clear?
Yes!
The 7 long years in this school is totally different from what we see outside. What we learn here is totally different and invaluable. We first see our seniors, we try to follow them, and when we commit any mistake, they punish us. And then we learn the things by doing it again and again. And then we become senior, we teach the same things to our juniors. And the trend and traditions go on.
Along with all the extracurricular activities, the paramount importance of academics is not lost. The academic session extends from 800 hours to 1330 hours in the classrooms that would easily qualify for the smart classrooms with the modern interactive methods of teaching.
To me, what motivates me to be at Sainik School is the fact that the system here is absolutely different from what other schools have. I mean, it's very peculiar. When I joined the school in class 6, when I was a small skinny nerd, I used to watch all the things which used to happen in the roll call, right from the school captain giving the Sadharan command, and then the house captains coming to give the reports, and then the very unison way of marching to the school, everything. I was amused by the way things went on. So the system which runs it, it's absolutely different, and the senior-junior relationship, we used to fear our seniors right from the top, and we used to respect our teachers, everything, right from the system to the way the discipline went on in the school. It was very good to watch because it was certainly very different from other schools.
Cadets are endowed quality education by a few hand-picked teachers from throughout the country, with the purpose maintained that one day they would lead troops of men for their motherland.
The school is affiliated to CBSE. For grooming overall personality, the emphasis is given to classroom teaching, CC activities, sports activities, particularly the NCC. The primary aim of the school is to help cadets to clear UPSC exam and finally join the NDA.
The academic curriculum follows the CBSE guidelines by the book, with regular assessments being carried out. The infrastructure is second to none, with a fully equipped science, maths and computer laboratories and lecture theatres.
And what is the color of solid?
Yellow.
Yellow. It is lead oxide.
Jack of all and master of some. This is what is expected of an officer. Physical fitness is made fun with various sports and athletics activities. The sports period is during the evening, an hour and a half long session supervised by the PTIs and professional coaches.
One thing which is different about Sainik schools is that the complete focus here is not on academics. Right from co-curricular activities to sports to any other activity which leads to the holistic development of a cadet, it's absolutely everything. Because for NDA, it's not like the other fields where you have to just be good at academics. For joining NDA, you have to be mentally, physically tough. Because if you don't get the punishments at Sainik School, you would not be able to survive at the National Defense Academy. So right from co-curricular activities to sports, the main focus of Sainik School is not just academics, but also other activities, which includes sports like volleyball, hockey, football, cricket, and co-curricular activities right from debate to declamation and cultural activities. All these would prepare a cadet for joining National Defense Academy.
यहाँ पे बच्चों को फुटबॉल, बास्केटबॉल, वॉलीबॉल, हॉकी इत्यादि गेम का भी प्रशिक्षण दिया जाता है, ज़्यादातर फुटबॉल, बास्केटबॉल, हॉकी, इन गेमों में बच्चों को ज़्यादातर टीम वर्क और फाइटिंग स्प्रिट उसको एक्सरसाइज किया जाता है।
Apart from the whole day routine, there is another activity who has taken place at the top routine of Sainik School, called NCC. Heroes are made on battlefield, but it is the training that makes soldiers. A cadet first exposure to combat tactics and arms and ammunition comes through NCC. The National Cadets Corps, established in 1948 with the purpose of to serve as the second line of defense. NCC in a Sainik school with perfect congruency training the cadets into drills and in war maneuvers.
Here in Sainik School, because starting from the day till the time you get back to the bed, everything here has to be done in a proper disciplined way, and knowledge of drill help us in doing so. Drill does not only consist of marching, but turnout, way of movement, talking with seniors, wishing seniors, everything.
Drill incorporates discipline and thus is a part of military training throughout the world. The sight of the cadets marching past with its steps falling into perfect unity. It generates a musical rhythm and an inspiring beauty.
Uniform is a very important part of the drill. It defines cadet. Uniform is respected by every cadet, every officer and every defense personnel. So here we also teach our juniors how to wear good and proper uniform. Starting from the boot to the beret, everything must be in a proper way in which that should be.
After a day training of physical and mental, evening period is given for the academics. The cadets ask their doubts, whatever they have been taught today, which is also called prep study.
Tibia is the penis bone, okay, and tibia is the shin bone. Shin guard also we are using during playing football.
After a hectic and tiring day of learning and training, the last event is the night roll call, during which well-being of the cadets is ensured by the senior appointments, who also addresses the various issues related to the conduct of the rally routine. The night roll call is concluded bright recitations of cadets' code of honor and the sound of echoing through the silence of the valleys which house this cradle of military leadership.
What should we have tomorrow?
Jump!
What should we have tomorrow?
Jump!
What should we have tomorrow?
Jump!
How's your spurs?
Jump!
Sainik schools were created with an aim to prepare cadets mentally and physically for the entry into National Defence Academy. But Sainik schools not only focus on academics, but right from sports, games, communication, extracurricular activities to all-round development of a cadet into a gentleman. Sainik schools boy, once they spend 7 long years in the school, they are molded in such a way that they can sustain anywhere. And this is the most demanding quality in the military life. Sainik school cadets are taught to be leaders, not only when they are in armed forces, but in all aspects of life.
Every year, a few good kids walk and a few good men walk out. Men who are true gentlemen with a desire to serve their motherland. Everything you learn here stays with you for life. You learn to tackle obstacles, you learn to have beliefs, and you learn to stand up for them. But most importantly, you learn to respect your motherland more than anything and everything.